Gene Simmons, and welcome to Legends on Film. That's me.
When I was a little kid, I wanted to be Gene Simmons.
And I bought my first real record, which was a Kiss album.
When I was a kid, I used to put on the makeup and throw little Kiss concerts in the backyard.
The very first band I was really listening to it was Kiss.
I was a big Kiss fan. I had all the posters, and like my wall, my bedroom looked like a Kiss shrine. Had the pillowcases and the sleeping bags and everything.
And when I seen Kiss, I said, I have to be a rock star. Right now I am one. I broke one.
After I seen Kiss, that was it.
That was it.
I like Peter Criss from Kiss, the drummer, and I started playing drums after I saw him.
I was a great Paul Stanley.
After 15 years now of Kiss, the fad band, the rock and roll glitch that would never stick around, never last, have you ever had a chance to actually confront one of these people who was so positive in print that Kiss was not going to do anything?
Success is its own reward, because people ultimately decide who they want to be stars. And especially if you've got any long-lasting career. I mean, it's nice to have a career 2-3 years. That's great. To do it for 15 years is like a gift. If you're religious, then it's a gift from God. And fans determine who lasts long. The only thing I ever wanted out of this was to get laid. You know, you put a guitar on, I want some of those girls, you know, and the more the merrier. I wanted to physically fuck myself to death. I wanted to see that piece of flesh that God gave me fall off my body. I wanted to punish it like it didn't. That's all I ever wanted. The platinum records and, you know, groups being influenced by the band, that's all cream.
Uh-huh.
Cream, get it?
Actually had the ability to warp certain young minds on a one-on-one level when you were a, God help us, school teacher. Is this correct, Jane? Now, what grade level did you teach?
Sixth grade.
Oh, Christ. And you taught sixth grade.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
I didn't last long. This reminds me of a funny story. You can keep it. I don't give a shit. The Newlywed Show. This is an American show, because I know this is going to be internationally distributed.
Right.
An American show where the host says, where was the most exotic place your husband ever made love to you? This is a true story. And the first, and there are four couples. Couple number one, where was, Bob, I'd have to say the bathroom floor was the most exotic place my husband ever made love to me. Thank you, couple number one. Couple number two, the most exotic place, I'd have to say it's my butt, Bob. I have to say this was on television.
What does Paul Stanley do? Sit around, eat brown rice, and read the Bible to, like, you know, like, balance this out?
I'm Carol.
Cindy, tell him.
No, Stevie, I'm Carol number three.
Right, and,
Carol number two?
Right, and you're...
I'm Carol number four.
I know who you're...
Carol number five.
Paul's doing great. You know, we're all out here writing material for the next album, our 23rd album. I can't fucking believe it. And in fact, we just signed a new contract, heaven help us, for another 7 albums.
Really?
Yeah. which is like forever. I'm gonna be like this old guy with no teeth, just a quivering mass of bones. Oh yeah, Kiss. It's gonna have to wheel me out on chair. Gene Simmons! Okay. All right! Say, I used to breathe fire when I was one of them.
Let's talk about your growing film career here, which is of interest. I saw you in Wanted Dead or Alive, and as a compliment, really, to your acting, even though you and I had met before, about 5 minutes after your character appeared on the screen,
yeah,
I had lost all identification with the person I knew, and I really hated this guy's guts.
Yeah, I know. I hated myself, too. I went to see a screening of the movie, yeah, the full audience and stuff, and the good guy was Rutger Hauer, and I played a real son of a bitch. This guy even patted a 12-year-old girl's head before she walked into a movie theater that he blew up. So I'm watching the film, and at the end of the film, there's a point where the hero is not gonna kill me. He's about to walk away, and you hear the audience going, "No! Kill this son of a bitch!" And I'm going, "Wait a minute, that's me, I'm not so bad, you know?"
Yeah,
but I guess in a very real way, it was a backhanded compliment. No more bad guys. When the band first started, all I could do was fantasize. Gee, it must be this, and it must be that, and it must be this. And then once you get it, it's an amazing high. And even though the high is still amazing, it's different. You can never get that first, but because, you know, the fantasy and all that's with it. So I know what it's like to get a platinum record. I've got 17 American ones on my wall now, and 20 gold.
Is that right?
20 American gold, 17 American gold, not counting the 68 or 69 other gold and platinum records from all over the world. So, to the guy that first said we were gonna last a week, you can kiss my ass.